Let us look at gallery walk, a very well-known cooperative learning strategy. The content that we will be covering up is introduction to gallery walk, steps of the gallery walk, advantages and challenges of implementing gallery walk. At the end of this session, you will be able to explain the steps for gallery walk strategy, discuss occasions for using gallery walk strategy, discuss advantages of using gallery walk, and list challenges in implementing gallery walk. Gallery walk cooperative learning strategy is an excellent way of breaking the monotony of the classroom. The students are compelled to get out of their seats, walk around, gain knowledge, discuss, debate, and also challenge the opinions put forward by their fellow students. This is a very, very flexible as well as a goal-oriented strategy. The teacher can design this strategy and initiate discussions among the students on varied topics. There are several steps of gallery walk strategy. Let us look at each of these steps. The step one, the teacher generates 5 to 6 questions which is displayed at different places in the classroom. These different places are called as the stations. For gallery walk, the students are teamed up in a group of 3 or 5. For example, for a class of 20 students, teacher may generate 4 to 5 questions. For larger classes, the teacher can generate more questions and repeat the similar set of questions. Care should be taken to display these questions at the different sections of the class. The second step is that of grouping. The teacher may group the students in groups of 3 to 5. Group size can vary depending upon the total population of the class. After grouping, the teacher must instruct the group members with respect to the roles that they have to play in that group. The third step involves beginning the gallery walk. The teacher directs the students to different questions or the different stations. At the first station, the team goes through the material that is displayed at the station. The team reads through the material, tries to understand the material, also comments on it, jots down the reflections, and looks at the exhibits in a careful manner. At the end of 3 to 4 minutes, the teacher says rotate. This is the cue for the team to move to the next station. On the teacher's signal, the students move to the next station. The teacher may instruct the groups to move in a clockwise direction. Once the students move to the next station, they read and discuss what has been displayed at that particular station. Not just the views that are put forward, but the views that have been put forward by the earlier group also are read by the new members arriving at this particular station. This is repeated until every group goes through each and every station. As this activity is happening, the teacher monitors the entire process and ensures that the groups move in a clockwise manner to every station that has been displayed. At times, the teacher may intervene, clarify the doubts, summarize the points, or propose new questions for the students to debate and reflect upon. This intervention by the teacher is essential in order to avoid any sort of misinterpretations or misunderstanding of the concepts by the students. The next step is that of reflecting and summing up of the activity. At the end of the activity, the teams go back to the first station that they had visited. They go through not just the views that were put forth by them, but also by other teams. Once again, they reflect, discuss and debate on the views that were shared by different members of different teams. The teams then summarize the responses. Any member of the group is asked to summarize and report the group findings and arrive at conclusions. This the teacher may do randomly in order to ensure individual accountability of every group member. There are several advantages of using gallery walk. It breaks the monotony of passive and sedentary lectures, especially engaging kinesthetic learners. It promotes higher order thinking as the students are constantly debating and discussing, looking and viewing and reflecting upon the views given by different learners. It also encourages students to come up with alternative approaches to a given problem. There are several challenges in implementing gallery walk. At times, there could be a lack of student response. A very shy student may not be willing to provide an opinion or a view about a question that is put up at the station. Or at times, there might be no student participation. That means that the student may be going around the stations but not really contributing the ideas or new opinions. There could also be a situation where some students could be very dominating and may not allow the weaker students or the shy students to participate. The gallery walk strategy also would involve some concerns about assessment. How assessment should be done in this kind of activity would remain a challenge for the teacher. The teacher may have to use a number of formative assessment techniques in order to ensure learning on the part of the students. So, in spite of several limitations, gallery walk strategy of cooperative learning can be very effective in breaking the monotony of the classroom. This strategy gives an opportunity to the learners to express their opinions, to share new thoughts. At the same time, it also allows the teacher to gauge the clear understanding of her or his students. This is an opportunity for the students to very quietly and in a very systematic way present their ideas, which may not be possible for them to do in a larger classroom. Hence, when effectively used by a teacher, ensuring specific instructions and clear transition cues, the gallery walk strategy can be extremely effective strategy that a teacher can use in her classroom.